Thank you. I hope you're having half as much fun as I am. I'm having a good time, thank you. So this album, Lost Highway, let me tell you a little story about it. We got off the road only last August. Typically, I take 2 years. One just to unwind and to get some brain cells to recycle. Another year to get some subject matter to write a record about and then go in and we cut it. In light of what was going on internally in the band for the first time, maybe in forever, between the loss of a couple of the guys' parents and some wives, and a lot of big changes went on in our lives, and it was obvious that instead of the big broad stroke socially conscious records, Have a Nice Day and Its Irony, or Bounce After 9/11, with this record, I just had to look inside and see, you know, the pain, but the trying to find that optimism in the idea that one chapter ends, another one begins. You see the light at the end of the tunnel, and the great unknown is what, you know, keeps you driving forward. So we went down to Nashville, and I'd been going there a lot for 20 years, sometimes just as an exercise. You know, you go down there and you hear songs and the songwriters, and you know, you suck up the scene down there. But this time, something magical happened. We went down there and just stuck ourselves in a hotel room, Richie and I, in a, not the same room, but you know, a hotel. And we just holed up in there. And any hotel that leaves you a legal notebook on the desk and writable CDs, you think, this place is all right with me. So we just start penning away. And, you know, he'll tell you that the subject matter on a song like the one we're about to do, he was thinking about his dad, who was, you know, of course, a dear friend of all of ours as well, and his passing. And I'll tell you, it's more about my relationship at home. And, you know, what makes the songs magic is it's not my story, it's not Richie's story, it's our story. And then it becomes your story. So this record, I think because it came from such a pure place, such a place of just artistic freedom and beauty, and there was nobody was expecting it, especially us. That's probably why it's doing so incredibly well. And, you know, of course, you might have heard by now, it's number one record everywhere in the world. And doing so well. But these stories are ours, you know, and I mean ours in the true sense that they're both of ours, all of yours and mine. And thanks a lot for, you know, being on that ride with us for the last 25 years, through the ups, the downs, and the ups again. It's called A Seat Next to You.
Your hand out the window, we're listening to the radio, and that's where I wanna be. On an old park bench in the middle of December, cold hard rain falling, can't find no cover. That would be alright with me. Hard days, good times, skies, dark nights, baby, I want you to take me wherever you're going to. Downtown bar with your head on my shoulder, smoking on a cheap cigar. That would be alright with me. In the back of a movie or a cross town train, I wanna hear your voice whispering my name. Yeah, that's where I wanna be. Dark nights, baby, say that you'll take.
spinning around, and when we get to the top, it's hard to look down. Just hang on, make it through. Save me. I see next to you. Get to that place where the angels sing. Go to that place where the church bells ring. No, I'll come running, running.